Greetings and welcome to episode 7 of my Napoleon Total War 3 Austro-Hungarian campaign, and this, my friends, I would have did last time, where we had a terrific battle, my friends, for Munich, and also where we intercepted quite a large Italian force here, Italy, a proxy of France, heading for Venice, trying to head for the port here of Chioggia, and we absolutely gave them a real thrashing, my friends. We absolutely mauled them. And also here, the French threw an absolute ton of troops against Munich. They really did send a huge amount of troops in against Munich, but we gave them such a thrashing that in fact they left it alone. I mean, look, this is all that's left here of the main assaulting army that attacked Munich, and it included Napoleon himself there. We've even got this army here, which is also remnants. We've got these armies here. Look at these armies here. They've been absolutely battered. And all we had is one army here. We had nothing else here apart from this one defensive army here. And they literally destroyed quadruple the number of troops thrown that were actually deployed in Munich. It destroyed 3-4 times its number. Quite a lot. And in that terms, look at that. It's thrown the French right back out of the way. They're doing some raiding here. But what that's given us, what that brave defense of Munich has given us, is time to build up forces in Prague here, which we are at the moment doing, as you can see. Not quite yet there full, but we're getting there. We're recruiting some really nice, look at that, these Dutch grenadiers, these German grenadiers here. Look at that, that is absolutely beautiful. 24 accuracy, 70 range, they really are. Look at the morale, 40. And we've got these gentlemen as well, the Dutch, the German Fusiliers. Okay, Dutch because I see Deutsche. The Deutsche Fusiliers. Fantastic troops. We really are giving ourselves a chance here. And we've also got this French army here just outside Salzburg here. That's going to, you know, they're on the way probably to here to Vienna to try and put us, to try and remove us from Vienna. This absolute hub here of our entire empire is Vienna. But my friends, you can see here we are indeed recruiting, building here a good army here. Elite Infantry Company here, and also some Deutsche Fusiliers here as well. Very, very good troops here. Tough troops. Disciplined troops is what we need. But we do have on the horizon, my friends, some brave allies here in the Russian, the guise of the Russians here. They've taken a long time to get themselves together here to help us. But at last we find ourselves now with aid coming here, coming through Budapest here, coming through Hungary. It looks like they're heading straight into possibly a collision force with this Gerard Rock here. Hopefully they're going to help us defend Vienna or even push back here and really give us some breathing space, give us some, you know, some room with which we can start to expand our economy as well. Because you can see we've got great estates here. Actually, I will put that into force, I think, this great estates here. That will definitely improve our economy, which we are looking to improve all the time, because money is very, very tight at the moment. We've, look at that, look at this army coming here down, all these armies, and they're actually coming through Lemberg, so they're actually coming through this sort of gap here in Hungary here, the Carpathian Mountains. They're coming all the way through here, and then, you know, marching their way through Budapest, through Hungary, and heading directly for the French here. So we're holding. We've also managed to put, because what we did have here, we had a sort of a small task force outside Stuttgart, outside Munich, I beg your pardon, and just before the battle started, we moved that small force into Prague, and it has formed the nucleus. It has formed the nucleus of the army you see now. We're putting together quite a powerful force here to defend Prague. Not brilliant. As you can see, we've got some sort of militia battalions here, but the rest of the army now is forming up quite nicely here. We've got to pick our fights, but if the French come for us, they will find equal vigour in defence here. We can't, I don't really want to repair this just yet, because if we lose Munich, all it means is we're just going to be able to repairing this for the French, which I don't want. As you can see here, we've got this really powerful sort of French force here, sat here waiting to come in. What about a peace here with Hessen? We've got Mecklenburg here. We've got the British here we're allied with, but they're not doing much here at all. The British, I thought the British had landed some troops to hit Paris, but they haven't. But look at Paris here. It's at, oh my word, look at that. They've absolutely got everything at full capacity here. Oh my god, look at that, wonderful troops they've got. Oh my word. Their troops they can pull together are absolutely fantastic. So we are nowhere near. We've got to defend these sort of regions we have under our control here with as much vigor as we possibly can. As you can see, our empire does stretch quite far, all the way up to the border here with the Russian Empire, and indeed the Ottomans down here in the south. We haven't quite got an alliance with the Ottomans yet, but we still got a good amount of trade with them, which is always useful. As our research here, we're trying to get logistics here, which is going to give us a +2 replenishment rate in all the regions, which we definitely do need, and a +1 to the army campaign movement range. But I think we can end this turn, my friends. We may... Munich is definitely under a considerable amount of threat here, because you can see a lot of these are going to take many, many, many years to replenish, which means the chances of them being ready to take any additional fights are pretty much zero. But that does not mean we just give in. We don't, my friends. As you can see, luckily, these gold mines here are on the Vienna side and not here in Munich. So we've still got access to these mines, which is definitely going to provide us not a huge amount of wealth, but it's still good for us. We can't really upgrade any of these because of the sort of the oh my god, look at that. Because of the threat here from the French here, or just absolutely heading straight for Vienna here, Austria, the absolute heartland of our empire. We really can't upgrade any of these. Engineering school would definitely give us 6-pounder, pioneer 12-pounder, 6-pounder. Oh, look at those 12-pounders here. Artillery battery, which I would like to get. Great museum. +16 town wealth. Oh, look at they. Oh, my word. They're actually not too bad at all. Weiner Freiwillige. I've said that absolutely horrifically. Oh, Vienna Volunteers. Excellent. Right, my friends, I think we can end this turn. Let's see what the French do now. Let's see what Britain does indeed. Let's have a look at France here. Oh, look at that. They've come straight for it. Yeah, there it is. It looks like Munich is going to fall. And we're not going to surrender. We are going to hold these forces here as long as possible. Oh, good grief. I mean, look at that. But can we do some damage here? We've got a minimal amount of men here. But can we really hit these here? Look at this force. It is absolutely brutal. Mind you, look at this. We've given these battalions a real hard hit. But that means they can replenish here. Once they've taken Munich, they'll be able to replenish. But we are outgunned here quite a lot. But we're going to take this fight. We're going to do some damage to them as best we can here. We've got cavalry. We've got 12-pounders. But once these men... I know it sounds really harsh, my friends, and pretty ruthless, but this is how we have to think. Once these regiments have been defeated, we can then freeze up more of these regiments for us to be able to use, especially some of these real crack battalions, just some of these elite battalions, especially these Deutsche Grenadiers, and also these gentlemen here, these Grenadier battalions. Absolutely fantastic. I've got a lot of militia here as well. Actually, these militia have got quite a lot in them, but these are going to be the backbone of the defence. We just want to do as much damage as we possibly can to these infantry regiments, really give them a real pounding so that it takes them a while to replenish before they can do anything to us. But let's take this fight, my friends, against the odds here. Jean Reynier and Dominique de Villars and Sigmund Donner, the defender. Don't forget them, my friends. Don't forget the defenders here of Munich. Don't forget them. They've laid down everything here to give us this opportunity, which is to be able to at least try and build ourselves a decent defensive force at least. We haven't got ourselves an attacking force, but maybe, just maybe, we might be able to put together an attacking force here. Maybe to help the Russians, as long as they keep sending those troops in. Who knows, they might even be able to take Munich back from the French if it falls. I really want to do as much damage as we possibly can to these French forces here, so it takes them a long time to replenish. Come on now, gentlemen, stand fast. Oh, look at this, what a wonderful sight. I wonder if we can go into these buildings here and really make it difficult for them. Maybe use this farmhouse here, this house here, as sort of the cornerstone of our defence. What a beautiful sight this is for it. 4th Regiment here, of course. Trying to keep our forces nice and compact here. They're hidden. Our best unit, which you can call it that. I think we'll put some of these grenadiers in here. Fill out this building here with them. Let's make this the absolute defensive position here. Oh, look at that. 13 men. 17 men here. Look at that. So this could be like the Alamo almost. We are sort of fighting against all the odds. Now our general, he's going to be staying here, just to give that cover here to the building here. Let's put all of our best... Oh, these gentlemen here. Okay, we've got quite a... Whoa. Okay, that should. Now we're going to have the artillery here.
Yes, sir.
Now, if we don't want to destroy our own buildings, what we will do is we'll just put the artillery here, in between here.
Yes, sir.
And actually, what we'll do is we'll put the cavalry, this small cavalry regiment we have here. It'll actually be the sort of the defensive position for this artillery, if you can call it that. We'll put them into that formation there, so it gives them a little bit of punch, a little bit of poke. Okay, let's get these gentlemen thus. Now, our militia are going to form the backbone of the defence here.
Yes, sir.
It's not going to be easy to hold. This will not be easy to hold at all.
Yes, sir.
Gentlemen, please. Terrain doesn't want to play, then we shall make it so. What we're not going to do is we're not going to go down without a fight. That is something we don't do. Actually, we'll put these two regiments here. One here. And one on the left flank as well. So we've got one on the left, one on the right. And these will form the nucleus of sort of a small reserve. We've actually got a small, I would say, a small plateau here. As you can see here, this hill here, but we've got all our best troops in here. Now, if they've got artillery, this is going to be pounded to pieces, but let's do this, my friends. The chances are we're going to be hit pretty hard anyway. Set these to charge anything that comes this way. My word, they've got some. Oh, good. What the blazes is going on here? Right. Steady, lads. Steady now. Hold here, hold, lads, hold. hope you gentlemen are going to do your work here. That's a lot of cavalry. That is a huge amount of cavalry. Good grief. One man with all those volleys. Oh, that's old. Wow. Flank us here. Get ready now. Doing everything we can in here now.
Our men are running!
Running, sir. This flank is completely and utterly broken. I said, lads, keep firing. He's going to absolutely swarm us. Oh, oh.
Our men are running, sir.
We can damage you as much as we can, lads. Fighting.
Our men are running first.
Of course they are. Look at this, blood. They've done a magnificent job here.
Because now we're outnumbered, we are.
Look at this. We fought at the last man. Remember the money.
All hope is lost. This battle is almost done.
Oh, that's all, dear.
Running, sir!
Of fatigue, sir, and must rest.
Stay back, stay. Stays and fights to the last.
He's killing his own men. He's actually shooting his own men. Here they come, they're trying to take the building by storm.
Defensive lines.
Yes, sir.
They've been broken, but by damn. Look at that, the building. Look how many they've killed around this building here. Look at this, defenses here. Look at that, the French, they've broken. They've completely broken. The 21st Regiment here, the France.
France thought they'd come in here from that small amount of forces here. We have a minuscule amount of men. And look at the damage they've done to the French army. They've absolutely butchered it.
Remember them, my friends. Remember them.
Oh,
entire unit is dead, sir.
Of course it is. But these men have been through, and yet they still hold. Chasseurs aval de la garde. The last remnants of the Munich garrison. The 18th Regiment of Militia. They hold, my friends, they hold. Fab. Don't be scared, lads. Don't be scared. It's all over. That's it, my friends. The defeat, the loss of Munich is real. But by my word, we can pay here. Close defeat. We knew that day was coming, but my word, we've made the French pay with their with everything they've got. They've thrown the best they can at us. And that defensive army there in Munich has held off six full French armies of elite troops. That is what they have faced, and we have absolutely mauled them, even though we've lost. Look at that, they've lost 403 and 1,420. A good amount of those were militia units. So they've lost nearly 500 men here. Okay, Munich has fallen, but now what? Now where do they go? Looks like they're going to reinforce here, this army here. If they come for Venice, then they will. Oh, here they come. I bet they go for Vienna. There it is. I knew it. Let's see what Russia does. Will Russia come and help us? Will Britain help us? Oh, come on, Austria. You've got to send some troops our way. Ah. Always good to see. Come on now. Yes, come on, Russia. That's it. Yes. Come on, Russia. Oh my gosh, they've done it. Oh my. Yes, we're doing this. We are definitely taking this. We're going to absolutely butcher this army here. We'll quickly save this, my friends. But look at this. The Russians are going for them. Oh my gosh, this could be our salvation here. I kid you not, my friends. We can butcher this French force here. Well, they got a lot of line infantry. That's good. But they've got a secondary force here coming in. And they're going to help us relieve here. What have we got? We've got our horse here, but they've got some really nice line infantry here. They've got Chasseur Epied battalion. They've got still got some grenadiers here. We've got Dutch grenadiers. Deutsche grenadiers. Please stop saying Dutch, Mala. Fusiliers. Ooh. Line infantry. God, they're pretty good actually. Heavy cavalry. Oh yes, we're going to do this. Let's take this fight, my friends. Let's do this. Attackers Mikhail Semenovich, Voronstov, Johann von Ostrich, and Adam Ivanovich Bistrom. Yes, the Russians have come through for us. They've actually come through for us, these allies of ours. And now they're starting to throw in a lot more troops into the region, which might be what we need to throw the French back. And if Britain was to join the war as well, it would be a beautiful sight. But we won't forget what the Russians have done here for us. It's taken them a long time to get to this point, but we will not forget what they've done. The Battle of Vienna.
1806, my friend. This is going to be a massive fight. But we have to hold Vienna. It is literally it is the heart of our entire empire here. I like it. Where are our allies coming in from? Can we actually come in from the side here and hit these? Because I don't want to be just... I think what we will do is... Oh, look at this. So in fact, these are all Russians here. We can't do anything here at all. Our troops will come into the battle soon. Let's do this then, my friends. Let's get this going. Yes. General Staff. Gentlemen. I think what we will do is we'll immediately hit these dragoons. We'll help our allies here. We'll carry this strike into the flank here. Oh, look at this. Two heavy horse. Gentlemen, steady now, lads. Steady. Oh, we got three regiments of horses. What a beautiful sight. We're not going to allow our Russian comrades to be hit here. We're going to go in with them. We're going to go in with them. Get in there, lads. Not going to allow our...
Our men are running,
sir. Don't just stand there, lads. We had to send our cavalry in then. We've got to give ourselves enough time here to form up.
Our men are running, sir.
That's it, we've brought them into the open here. Yes, they've come back. Well done, lads. Oh, and they've come back as well. That's really crushing this French flank here. Now we're going to sit and wait now. We're going to sit and wait. Let's bring all our troops into here. They're running. They are really running. They've come back. Just let's steady them. Let's just steady them. Oh, look at all these troops. It's a beautiful sight. Get into them, lads. Gotta break this flank here. Yes. Come on, Russia, don't you break. Don't you dare break now. Now let's get up into this fight. Russia, don't you break, Russia.
The men are fatigued, sir, and must rest a while.
Oh my god, Russia is absolutely breaking all over the shop here. Yes, that's it. Come on, Russia, down your hole now. Breaking now. It's a wonderful sight. We've lost a lot of troops here, but by damn, it's been worth it. That's right, push them hard, lads. Push them hard.
We have killed their general, sir.
Yes.
Now they must break.
Protect them. Protect the Russians. Protect the lads. Oh, no, they're breaking. They're breaking all along the front. The combined might of Russia and Austria. Broken them. So hold, lads. Hold there. That's it. Well done, Russia. Well done. It's given us a firm foothold here now. And they've come back. They have come back. Alright, sit down some of these running forces here. Back here, but I don't like to see that. That's it, well done, Russia. You've been absolutely brutalized here. Come on, lads, don't just look there. Move it. Oh, look at this absolute massacre. The Shashes are still left here, and so the Wurttemberg Grenadiers, look at that, they really are. Oh, what a shot, they really are. Russia has given all here for us. Kill them all. Let's kill this regiment here. Of cavalry. Of artillery even. If you would please, gentlemen, please move before
glorious
you are killed.
Glorious victory, sir!
Yes.
Is soon to be yours!
These are moving back. I think it's time that we moved in. Street fighting is the worst here. But they've all started to come back here. getting close. The least we can do is run here. Yes. I have no idea what these stragglers are doing here. Let's go with the fifth horse. It's getting hand to hand with a stack of trimmings. This Barbie Grenadiers, let's kill them all. So France doesn't return back to Venice. Dirty here, my friends. We've killed every single one of them there. Bad mean and poofy daddy. I'm not sure there's a peed.
The men are fatigued, sir, and must rest a while.
Are they fatigued? Are they fatigued? Kill them all. They won't be coming back to Vienna anytime soon. With the help of our Russian allies, we did it. A wonderful victory there. What a fight that was. Yes. He lost almost everything. 2,538 men have been killed. And our good ally here lost 1,489 of 8,000 men he's deployed here. Wow, look at that. He's been absolutely butchered. And looks like they're coming here to help defend here. Oh my gosh, that is so fantastic. Our glorious ally. Ah. Don't do it, Spain. Don't you dare. Bavaria lost. We knew that was coming. We knew that was coming here. That's something we've got to put up with. Yep. But he fought with bravery. Ooh. Okay. Yes. Bohemia. We're still slowly building up here. Yes, we can get grenadiers here. And we know Bavaria was lost. And what about here? Now look at that army there. It's been absolutely butchered. Oh yes, and we can recruit here, which we are doing. Actually, we can get rid of these. It's taking far too long. Oh yes. They'll be worth it. 3492. Oh. Reserve cavalry. Four. Kaiser Franz is second hip. I think we'll have one of those regiments as well. Actually, that's quite a bit of money to spend on that. But what can we put here? What will that give us? The Court of Appeal. Engineering School. But we've, oh my gosh, we've given the French a real pasting here. And we've also got these gentlemen here as well now. And looks like the Russians are coming over here to help us here in Venice. So it looks like we've managed to stabilise the front here. But having the secret society, there's no point in that. If we repair this, oh that's now French. Supply depot. Plus 4 replenishment in this region. It's being replenished there. Oh, look at that. We've got more Russian troops moving in. Russia could help us tip the balance here in our favour. It really could. Which would be fantastic. Steam powered sawmill. Look at that. And they're sending more troops through here as well. Ooh. We go for that there. That's definitely going to be worth it. But my friends, I'm going to end this episode right there, my friends, on a victory where we held Vienna. Actually, we held more than held Vienna. We absolutely only got his 4 regiments left, and even these have been absolutely pulverized. That is a wonderful, wonderful victory there for us. It really has boosted us. And now we've got our Russian colleagues here, Russian comrades here, helping us hold both Venice and Vienna. We might be able to put together a strike force which we can hit back at the French here, maybe even taking Munich back. But still, they've got a lot of moving into the region here, France. But if Britain was to really help us out here and move, look at this army here. If they were to put this army in French territory, it would cause havoc behind the lines here. But my friends, I'm going to end this episode here. Hope you've enjoyed it. If you have, please comment, like, and subscribe. And as always, my friends, please keep your comments coming. Actually, I'll put a trade, just before I go, put that trade company there into action there. Please comment, like, and subscribe as always, my friends. And as always, your comments, they have been absolutely, absolutely fantastic. Please keep them coming down below. They have been wonderful. They really helped me and shaped me all my campaigns. And this one is no exception. So hope you're having a good week. Hope your week continues on. Please be safe whatever you're doing. And until next time, my friends, bye for now.